Hey guys, how's it growing? Jackson here with another video. And today I wanted to talk about one particular plant. And that plant is the Jabotacaba. So right here, I got my big Sabra and it's pushing out a ton of new growth. Just a massive amount of new growth. And what we got right here, whoa, what? This is Jabotacaba fruit. Now this tree didn't make this fruit. I got this fruit from a grower in Florida. Yeah, look at that. These guys are super good. But eventually this guy right here will make just as much fruit as what I got in here, which is a little over a pound. And these guys fruit like 3 to 4 times a year once they get established. But it takes about, for this variety, 8 to 12 years. So it's quite a long time. But I got some fruit. You buddy. So I'm pretty happy about that. These guys are in the Myrtaceae family. Its scientific name is, or its botanical name is, Plinia cauliflora, and cauliflora pretty much means coliferous production. And what that means is that these guys will make fruit right on the trunks of the trees, so like right there, which is pretty neat. And the fruit's super good. It tastes like a grape. It kind of has like a cherry tang to it. And the skin is kind of astringent. You don't really want to eat the skin, but the skin is high in antioxidants, so that's really cool. Just hold on 1 second. I'm going to bring these guys out and give you guys a better look at my Jabotacabas. Hold on 1 sec. And we're back. So here is my big old 19-gallon Sabra Jabotacaba. This is what I have in the greenhouse. I just brought some out to show you guys, but a little bit of what I got. I didn't want to bring out all the Sabras. But here's a nice looking one. The tallest one I got. It's about six or so years old. Not ready to fruit yet. These guys take about, like I said, 8 to 12 years to fruit for this Sabra variety. But they do really well here in Zone 9B. They don't really need that much protection. I had this guy in my greenhouse just because I didn't really want to stunt growth. Because with your tropicals, they can pretty much grow all year round since most of the time they're in a tropical environment. So you don't really want to stunt that growth. So I try to keep it as warm as possible in my unheated greenhouse. But you can see all that new growth. It's really pretty. It's kind of fuzzy at the tips. A little bit of a fuzziness. I don't know if you'll be able to tell. But these guys are really good. They like a lot of water. They like wet feet. They like lots of mulch, lots of organic fertilizer. I water these guys with rainwater now. And they seem to like it a lot better. I know that where I live, there's a lot of chlorine and stuff in our water, so they don't really like it. They get a lot of spots on them. But this is like a shell chelated iron on those leaves. They've just been there for a while. These guys, once they're established, they fruit up to 3 to 4 times a year, which is super cool. Because who doesn't love fruit like almost all year round? I know I do. That would be sick. That's why I got this guy. They like acidity in the soil, so that's why I use the peat moss. But since peat moss is kind of just like basic in terms of when you get it, it's pretty basic. I add a lot of like mulch and fertilizer and stuff into my soil mix. Make sure you guys water them a lot. give them lots of sun. Well, they like dappled sunlight. Don't give them full sun if you're out here in California, because that'll fry them. That will fry these guys. Especially the trunk. Especially because you want Jabotocabas to be open like this, where the sun can get into this trunk right here, because that's the sun helps it flat. Once it's mature, it'll help it flower, and you need that sunlight to hit the trunks in order to flower. So if you have these guys out in full sun here in California and you got it open like this, like how this tree is, it's just gonna get fried in the sun. But yeah, the fruit is really good. It's like pretty much like a Concord grape, but it has kind of this like cherry tang to it. That's like the easiest way I can describe it. The skin, it's kind of herbally. It tasted a lot like that Chilean myrtle I have in here in the greenhouse. But it's really good. The from flower to fruit, it takes up to 30 days to get fruit. And which is super quick, but the only bad problem about that is that shelf life isn't very long, so these guys, the fruit will dissipate pretty quickly. But these guys have such a pretty bark. These guys are related to those crepe myrtles that you see around your neighborhoods and stuff. These guys peel just like them. But these guys are a lot more cooler than crepe myrtles, even though those are really pretty trees when you don't chop them up like people usually do. And so these guys right here, these are really cool because they are red hybrid Jabotocaba. It is a cross between the Sabra variety and the white Jabotocaba, which is Plinia aureana. And I don't have a white Jabotocaba, but soon, hopefully I will, or a few. They're a really cool tree. They have really cool leaves. I'll probably have a picture right above. These guys fruit a lot quicker than the Sabra, usually 3 to 5 years from seed. They make a nice red fruit. The skin is, I guess, a little less astringent than the regular Sabra variety, but you can eat them a lot. I guess you could eat them whole a lot easier than a Sabra. Even though the skin on the Sabra is not that herbally, at least the ones I just tried. But I think they're doable. I might use the skins and try and make a tea or something with them. We'll see. I don't really want to waste the skin. But anyway, back to these guys. They do like it acidic. They do like lots of fertilizer, lots of mulch. I just fertilize these guys, that's what that is, and up there. Lots of net organic fertilizer, lots of compost, lots of mulch. And yeah, I keep these guys in some dappled sunlight. They kind of got wrecked this winter. Not bad, but they look a little rough. But that's because I had them here in the outside. But they're doing good. This guy I got from Morton & Sons Nursery, from John and Travis Morton. You can find him on Facebook. You can find him on eBay. He sells a lot of cool plants, a lot of Jabotocabas. He's really, really in the game. And then this one, this red, I got from Adam from Flying Fox Fruits. This guy, he's like the man to talk about Jabotocaba with. Look him up on YouTube, look him up on Instagram, look him up on Facebook, he's there. So yeah, check him out. And another thing I wanted to point out is, so you can see on this red, there's about 3 trunks that come up. And so, Jabotocaba are polyembryonic, meaning that they could have multiple plants on one, growing out of one seed. So, I'm not sure if this was multiple seeds, because Adam sometimes does that. What I've seen on his streams and stuff, that he'll put multiple plants together and just sell them as one, because So he gets a lot of seeds and screw picking that out. And I don't blame him. But this could be a polyembryonic seed. It's having three trunks come out here, but I'm not too sure. It might be multiple seeds. But that's always a possibility you might get when getting some of these trees. And then, oops, right here, this is just a little Sabra, Jabotocaba. I got the seeds last August or no, October or so, and this is what I've got so far. Hopefully they'll get a little bit bigger this year, as the growing season occurs. But yeah, is there anything else to think about? Anything else? No, nothing else. I will probably have a Jabotocaba tasting fruit tasting video up pretty soon. You know, I'll probably have some other fruit tasting videos up soon. Hopefully I can get more Jabotocaba videos out soon. I hope you guys are really interested in this species of plant as much as I am, because I think these are really cool. I definitely recommend anyone to get these. You could have these inside, you could have these outside, depending on your zone, but you could have them inside. Just know what your how your climate is inside, like humidity and whatnot. Just think about things outside the box. And yeah, there's a ton of varieties. There's so many varieties. There's more than I can even think about. And you know, you can get back on, like, this is just something you can get back on, like give back and get back, and something a little pretty rewarding once you get some fruit started, or you see some new growth going. It's just really fun to grow these things and share with the people around you, you know. So yeah, I hope you like this video. Like and subscribe. Hopefully I can get some more Jabotocaba varieties this year. We're pushing for a few more. You know, I only got three varieties. I got the Sabra, I got the blue Vexador. I got some seeds, but they're not popping yet. I gave some to my friend and they're popping. I gotta get a grow tent pretty soon, because everyone seems to be getting those grow tents, and that would help a lot growing these things. But I'll have some more videos coming out soon about different plants. Just let me know in the comments what you'd like to see more of. Like I said again, like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in another video. Peace.